Lily S. White is joining us now, and she's one of the stars of Dreamgirls at a fantastic show at the Schubert Theater. Welcome, Lily S.
Thank
you.
It's good to be here.
Now, you play Effie White on the matinees.
Right.
Right? How long have you been doing it?
Oh, a couple of months now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
In reading about you, you say when you first come on stage, the first 15 minutes, the audience is a little hostile.
Yeah, that happened a lot more so in the beginning than it has recently. I think that audiences are now aware of the fact that Jennifer is not there on the matinees and that I am standing in, and so they're ready for that. It's some of the evening audiences now that still have that reaction. They sort of sit there waiting and watching to see what's going to happen and how they're going to feel, and at the end of the first act, they're really sold.
They're sold, huh?
Yeah.
When you do that number, I'm telling you, I'm not leaving you, must be an incredible charge for you as a performer to be able to sing that.
Yes, it is.
Is that like just an amalgamation of all your emotions?
Well, not quite, but it does mean a lot. First of all, it made theater history.
Yes.
It made theater history, that number, the show itself and that number by itself. It's won all kinds of awards, Grammy Awards and Tony Awards. So it is a big charge, and it's a big challenge to have to step into Jennifer Holliday's shoes and do the number and still have the impact that that everybody's waiting for.
What do people tell you after they see you do the show?
A lot of people are speechless. They really can't say anything. They're just not sure. They're totally so involved emotionally.
Yeah.
So they're speechless a lot of times. But I've had a lot of big, strong, grown men say that they were in tears.
Including me.
Including you.
Including me, yeah. Now, this is loosely based on the Supreme story. I mean, I guess...
Very loosely.
Right. I believe Diana Ross has not seen the show.
That's what we're told. But we were also told that Diana Ross did one of the numbers from the show in her concert.
In Central Park? Really?
Yeah. Yeah, so we don't really know the whole scoop on that. It doesn't matter. The show is a hit, whether...
Well, seriously, but in other words, the story is these three girls who start together.
Yeah.
And then you are the lead singer.
Right.
And then some...
And I'm replaced, and my best friend, Dina, is put into the lead spot because our manager, Curtis Taylor Jr., thinks that it's going to look better with Dina in the forefront.
Curtis is your manager.
Right, and he's also my boyfriend.
Yes. And there's a little moment at the beginning there where you say to him something about, have I ever told you about your, when I like a man, what is it that
when
you
I
say?
When I like a man's eyes, it's very serious.
Yes.
Very serious.
It is serious.
Yes.
Huh? How serious is it?
It's so serious.
That's great. Now, Michael Bennett directed this.
Yes.
And he must be incredible to work with. What is he like to be directed?
Oh, he's a lot of fun. He's a lot of fun. He's got a tremendous amount of energy and talent, and the ideas just, you know, roll from him. And I feel very fortunate because he did not make me a clone. He didn't want to clone Effie White. He wanted to make her, he wanted to pull out of me who Effie was from my perspective. And it works.
Mm-hmm.
It works.
There's some similarities because you're a single mother.
Yes.
Right? So that's some relate. The same last name.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
The same last name. And
and they pad you, don't they?
Yes, they pad me for the first act.
Why do they pad you?
Well, because there are a lot of inferences made to Effie being overweight in the first act.
Mm-hmm.
And it also makes more sense when she comes back in the second act to have, and when she sings, I'm changing. To really have changed and have lost the weight and to really have this wonderful look and be glamorous and different from the person that she was 7 years before.
I noticed one thing, the choreography when you start walking down stage when you do the song I'm Changing, is kind of a walk that a heavy set person, that they're kind of a walk.
You mean when I do I'm Telling You?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you feel that... I mean, my feeling was it was like maybe they should change the walk a little bit because it's you and you're not that heavy.
Well, I hadn't thought about it, and I wasn't aware that it looked that way. But Effie is supposed to be, you know, overweight, and at that point she's pregnant.
Uh-huh. So that might be the reason
she's
for the
walk. Pregnant. I shouldn't give that away, should I?
Oh,
well.
There's so much to see in that show that then you're not going to give anything away. And the young man who plays Jimmy, what is his name again?
That's Jimmy Early.
Yes.
James Thunder Early. That's Clinton Derricks Carroll.
He is magnificent.
Yes, he's
really
great to work with, too.
Tremendous
cast. Wonderful energy. Yes.
Have you and Jennifer sat down and discussed the role? Do you talk about it? Not at all.
Not at all.
She does her thing, you do yours.
Yeah.
Your background, you're from Brooklyn originally.
From Brooklyn, yeah.
Yay, Brooklyn, right? Brooklyn. And you studied with the gentleman who wrote The River Niger.
Yes, Joseph A. Walker and his wife, Dorothy Dinwell Walker. And I really thank God for them because they are responsible to a great extent for where I am now and who I am.
What do you have to do to get into training to do that show? I mean, do you have to get extra rest? Do you have to do certain warm-ups vocally?
Yes, you have to rest. I warm up. I try to do it every day, even though I'm not on every day. I try to do some kind of vocal work every day. You have to do a lot of rest. You get a lot of rest on this show because it's singing. The whole show is a song, and it's a heartbeat kind of pace, and you have to keep that pace. So you have to get a lot of rest, or else your voice sounds like... Ugh.
Yeah, you know what I felt at the end of the show? I sat there and I watched the actors taking their bows, and I thought there was a tremendous pride.
Oh, yes.
For A, the black performer, and B, the black person. A tremendous pride. It was very moving. Do you feel any of that?
Absolutely. Absolutely. When we get to that finale, where the dream girls are reunited and all the dream girls are together, Effie and all the dream girls are together, there's a great amount of pride in the fact that we are holding hands and sometimes very, very teary-eyed and saying we're dream girls and we made it and we've survived all the problems.
All the problems. Well, a thing that we'd like to do right now is Meredith McRae and myself would love to do the little number that you do, Dream Girls. We'll play back.
Oh,
this is Meredith. Lily is Meredith.
Yes, we met. And your daughter's in the green room, and she's darling.
She's the youngest member of the Dream Girls cast.
She's petting the seals, and she told me that I smell yucky.
Oh, no.
She's right.
We're going to play the song, Dream Girls. You're going to be out front.
Are we going to lip sync?
Lip sync,
okay.
Yes.
Are we? Okay.
Yes.
I'm game for anything, guys.
If you want to sing along, fine.
Okay.
You be creative if you want to.
Oh, we got our wires tangled.
Oh, you be here.
Okay.
One side.
Ladies and gentlemen,
be ready.
The Dream Girls
is proud to present the club debut of America's new recording stars, the Dreams.
It's good enough.
Every man has his own special dream, and your dream's just about to come true. Life's not as bad as it may seem if you open your eyes to what's in front of you.
Dream girls.